Welcome back to Chem Reactor. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the peroxide formation in diethyl ether. Diethyl ether is a widely used solvent in academic research due to its low cost and high volatility. However, it possesses a significant risk associated with the formation of the peroxide over the time. When this diethyl ether comes in contact with the aerial oxygen and sunlight, it forms this explosive hydroperoxide. And the presence of this hydroperoxide in diethyl ether presents a significant risk to the laboratory workers as well as the property. Here is the mechanism of hydroperoxide formation in diethyl ether. The aerial oxygen in the presence of sunlight forms this oxygen radical. This oxygen radical abstracts the hydrogen radical from this diethyl ether molecule to give this diethyl ether radical. This diethyl ether radical reacts with another oxygen radical to form this diethyl ether hydroperoxide. So this diethyl ether hydroperoxide radical again abstracts the hydrogen radical from this another diethyl ether molecule to form this diethyl ether hydroperoxide. Along with this, it gives this diethyl ether radical. This is basically a chain reaction. Once this initiated, it accumulates more and more diethyl ether diethyl ether hydroperoxide, and that's how it possesses a risk or danger to the laboratory or the property. So then how to stop this formation of explosive hydroperoxides in diethyl ether? There are many radical scavengers available in the market, but the most common one is a butylated hydroxytoluene called a BST that removes the free radicals required for the peroxide formation in diethyl ether. Here, the peroxy radical of this diethyl ether abstracts this hydrogen radical from this BST molecules and releases this diethyl ether peroxy molecule along with the BST radical. This BST radical rearranges to this intermediate 6, which have a more accessible radical from here away from this two tertiary butyl groups. So this BST radical reacts or the forms bond with another peroxy radical of diethyl ether and gives this BST peroxy radical adduct. So that's how in total it gives or the quenches or mitigates two peroxy radicals from this diethyl ether and stops this chain reaction of formation of peroxides in diethyl ether. Then the safety measures. Diethyl ether hydroperoxide is known for its explosive property, and that's why it's very important to follow the safety measures to minimize the risk associated with this handling of diethyl ether or the storage. The first one is use of personal protective equipment. Always wear a gloves, goggle and a lab coat. The second one is storage and handling. Always store diethyl ether in cool and dark place away from direct sunlight and the source of heat. The third one is proper labeling. It's very important to clearly label the diethyl ether containing bottles. The next one is ventilation. Work in the well ventilated area such as a fume hood to minimize the inhalation of diethyl ether vapors. The fifth one is avoid reactive materials. Keep diethyl ether away from strong acids, alkalis or any other reactive materials that can react with diethyl ether. The sixth point is a regular inspection. This is very important point here. Always inspect your diethyl ether container. Is there any solid deposit or the crystalline deposit at the bottom of your diethyl ether bottles? The seventh one is always avoid contamination. Always use clean glassware or dry glassware on the equipment to avoid introducing any contaminants to your diethyl ether bottles. The eighth safety measure is testing and monitoring. Periodically test ether for the presence of hydroperoxides using this type of test strips. Those are easily available from the market. The ninth safety measure is a disposal. Always discard the diethyl ether bottles that show some sign of peroxide formation in it. And then at the end, always refer to the specific safety data sheets that provided by the manufacturer for detailed information on handling diethyl ether and its hydroperoxides. Additionally, comply with the relevant safety regulations, guidelines in your laboratory or the workplace. I hope you enjoyed the video, and please don't forget to like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.